For one moment, I want you to think about something else that is there. At first, I just couldn't believe what was happening, but there are things going on you need to know about. And that is 8 years ago, the state of the central banks throughout the world was that all of the that the Rothschilds and the banksters had acquired the banks and the currency and all the financial dealings of all the countries in the world except for six countries. Let's see if I can name them offhand. There was holdouts, and they were all by dictators, and they refused to go along with handing over all their currency and losing all control of their money. And these countries were Afghanistan, Iraq, Iran, Libya, Cuba, and one more. I can't think of it at the moment. I'll come up with it. But then, so what happens? The U.S. government produces the visa photos of 19 Saudi Arabians. And so then we go and invade Afghanistan, which had absolutely nothing to do with 9/11. And after we do that, we go and invade Iraq, who had nothing whatsoever to do with 9/11 either. But at this point, their funds were now in the hands of the U.S., who gave it to the central bank, I don't know how the dealings went, of course, but now this so-called rogue list, that was the Bush gave him that name, that these were rogue nations. Well, they just didn't want to turn over their money to the Rothschilds. And well, they shouldn't, but they were isolated and they were punished for doing so. And then they got overrun by U.S. in its empire building, I think. And so two banks were left. I mean, two banks were moved over into the column of that they were that the Rothschilds had their money. And I think these were pretty solvent countries, even though they had been so badly, their economies were just, they were under sanction and blockades and everything else. But nevertheless, and both these countries have a lot of